about to be different. Our memories will help us see the light. We are all gathered now for one last time. The moment's finally come. We join our hands together to show the tears, the ups and downs through all these years. We have finally realized that each of us is a gift. The smiles and the worries we've shared. We know that God has called each of us to love one another, and show that we care. Let's face the future now and make our dreams a reality forever. We thank you, Lord, for everything we've gone through. Life would have been meaningless without you. We can't forget the laughter and the tears, the ups and downs through all these years. We have finally realized that each of us is a gift of love.
It's a gift of love.
We thank you, Lord, for everything we've gone through. Life would have been meaningless without. Tears, the ups and downs through all these years. We have finally realized that each of us is a gift of love. Thank you, Lord, for the people and the times we've learned.
kapampangan misakwak, kinleguanan ing alaya, gabunding pantas at marangal, sibul ning lubut karinan ing tepangan. Batis ning katalaruan at panamdam makabanen ligayami ingye payama king malugut mong kandungan kapampan salening leguan kapampangan sandalan ing katimawan kilugding usumi atin kang dambana pangan luit ka palsintan ming kapampangan kapampangan sadening leguan kapampangan sandalaning katimawan kilu atin kang dambana luit ka palsintan ming kapampangan luit ka palsintan ming kapampangan.
Joyful greetings to everyone, especially to our dear parents, grandparents, guardians, family members, and friends of our graduates, completers, and achievers for this school year 2020-2021. May I also recognize the presence of Mrs. Andrea Serna, our academic coordinator, Mrs. Elisa Lahap, our student activities and services coordinator, our faculty members, non-teaching staff, and our honorees for this occasion. Welcome to our second virtual end of the school year culminating activities. Graduation for our grade 6 pupils and grade 12 students, moving up ceremony for our grade 10 students, and recognition for our undergraduate achievers, both in the academic and non-academic areas. It has been more than a year now since the outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic. And this pandemic derailed our plans and disrupted our activities. We are aware that change is normal in our life. As Heraclitus once said, the only constant in life is change. Changes have been happening in our life since birth. We accept that change continues to take place. That is why we prepare for these normal changes in our development, anticipate and monitor them. But this time, the change brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic has been so drastic. We were caught by surprise with this worldwide pandemic. It made us pause for a while in what we were usually doing. However, despite the community quarantine, the enhanced community quarantine, modified enhanced community quarantine and lockdowns, we have come to realize that the education of our children must go on. So we had to plan and make adjustments in order to provide for the continuity of learning for our pupils and students. Borrowing from the words of Socrates, he said, "The secret of change is to focus all your effort. The secret of change is to focus all your energy not on finding the old, but building on the new." Thus, we had to develop a new way of delivering our educational services. We made an inventory of our school facilities and equipment. Likewise, made a survey on the availability of internet, computers, and gadgets of our pupils and students before deciding on the modality of learning that we should adopt. From the findings, we came to decide that we can provide online distance learning, or ODL. Thank God, our resources, with some upgrading, made it possible to implement online distance learning. Thanks to the readiness of our teachers to provide for online teaching using different social media platforms. Having grown into this digital world, they possess the information and technology skills for this learning modality. Their versatility in social media enable them to use different platforms. There's the teacher's skills, knowledge, and competencies in carrying out online instruction were further enhanced through the webinars conducted by the Department of Education, the Private Education Assistance Committee, the Center for Educational Management, and other partners. Teaching online has become part of the new normal for our teachers and students. With this learning modality, our pupils and students were able to divert the use of the computers and gadgets for educational purposes other than games, watching movies, and the like. Thank you, my dear parents, for the support and guidance you provided your children to adjust to this new modality of learning. This provided the motivation and encouragement to move on in their studies with zest and zeal. As we close the school year 2020-2021, we have come together to celebrate and thank the good Lord for making all this happen successfully. Today, we are recognizing their achievements and celebrating their success for making it to the finish line. This occasion is also a celebration and thanksgiving for you, my dear parents, grandparents, guardians, teachers and staff, and all those who took part in the education and formation of our children. Your efforts and sacrifices have paid off. Thank you for your dedication, patience, and perseverance in promoting our children's welfare and development. Let us continue our partnership and work together to build a better future for our children. Aside from the grade 12 graduates who will be moving on to college, we hope to have back your children by school year 21-2022. May God bless us all. Thank you.
Dr. Javier, I would like to present to you our grade 12 students who have successfully completed the requirements prescribed by the Department of Education for senior high school.
By the power vested in me by the Department of Education, I, as the school head, declare you as graduates of the senior high school course with all the rights and privileges appertaining to.
Okay, no need to, you know, Mr. President, King, don't worry, I will not do the whole fiasco thing I did 2 years ago during my graduation speech. I'll just give a speech and that will be it. So, first of all, I would like to extend my congratulations to all San Lorenzo students for their recognition and for receiving their academic rewards. To my fellow batchmates, I say this, finally. We are now done with too much homeworks, projects, researches, and all that stuff. We are now finally graduating. Now I know it's going to be hard. We're, you know, finally going to be separated, each following our own dreams, our careers, our college. It will be, yes, it will be sad, but just know this, that we're finally entering unknown waters. We're going to college. We're going to meet new friends, new teachers, new people, new subjects, new challenges. Since this is just a virtual graduation event, and by the time you're watching this, this likely will be a recording, let me at least just give a few remarks. First, we need to step up. We need to learn what it's like to give our best. When I was starting in San Lorenzo, I started giving my best. I can't tell why. For some reason, whenever you give your best, there's always gonna be this reason. And no need to pressure naman. Just, you know, keep going. Don't give up. It's very important. Especially when we're in college, with all those new, unexpected challenges. The next one I want to say is, no matter what your dreams, your future, your career, what school you're going, it doesn't matter even you're going to a normal university while your friends are up in Manila or somewhere. Here's the thing. Don't be discouraged by what you think is less. Because always remember that God has a plan for everyone. We may start small, but always remember that we will not finish small. So always remember that don't let circumstances define who you are. Whether it be the pandemic, your finance, it doesn't matter. There's always a way. In a way, you just need to, you know, not give up and don't think too much of the problem. That's very important. So all in all, just as what Mr. John Keating said in Dead Poets Society, carpe diem, seize the day. Because sooner or later, and I say to all of you watching, all of us will turn cold, will stop breathing, and die. So while we're still young, while we still have life in us, whether still even you're just even adults watching this, there's always still hope and always still time. We just need to make sure to, you know, do what's best, give our best, and always pray to God. May he be with me, may all our works be in his glory. So thank you very much. I extend my congratulations again to my fellow batchmates. Hopefully, even though we're, you know, separated, we may still meet each other through social media. I look forward to, you know, seeing you once again. Farewell.
To everyone, parents, friends, teachers, classmates, I wish you all a good day. I hope that everyone is doing well despite the ongoing pandemic we are facing. First of all, I would like to congratulate our batch for our graduation despite having virtual classes instead of face-to-face classes. To everyone, a job well done. As we add another achievement to our batch, I would like to remind everyone that we have so much more to face in the future. Not everything will be favorable for us, but not everything will be against us. We would face defeats, but we would also claim victories. Not all of our dreams will come true, and we should know when to give up on a dream, but we should never stop on dreaming. You can give up on a dream, but you should never give up on yourself. I would like to share my favorite quote from the philosopher Heraclitus. He said that no man ever steps on the same river twice, for it is not the same river, and he is not the same man. In life, we may sometimes face problems that we would also face in the future. So we should treat problems and failures as opportunities for us to learn, so that we would be equipped with knowledge from our experience when we face that problem again. We could never be perfect as a person no matter what we do, but we could use everything that we have learned to solve our problems and to be the best versions of ourselves. We all know how difficult the past year has been for all of us. To our parents, our teachers, and to everyone working hard for our future, we salute you. Most of us have been affected by what is happening in one way or another, but today is a day to be celebrated. We have reached the end of our high school days. We have reached another milestone in our lives. All the sleepless nights we've spent in completing our assignments, projects, and theses have finally paid off. SLR has taught me there is more to being a great student other than academics. That a great student should also know how to respect others, how to work with others, how to learn from others, how to have fun, how to accept that we are only human and that we can make mistakes, how to be human. For that, I thank our school. I would like to thank my parents, my family, all of my teachers, all of my friends, and God for helping me through everything. Without them, I would not be where I am in my life. On behalf of all my classmates, we would like to thank everyone that has been a part of our journey. After 4 years of being an SLRian, I guess this is goodbye. I say my final goodbye as an SLRian, not only as farewell, but also as God be with you in every step of your journey. May God guide all of us, and may we never forget to thank and glorify Him. Walk tall, my friends. May we all be successful when we see each other in the future. Once again, congratulations to all of us, and God bless us all.
Greetings, fellow graduates, parents, teachers. First and foremost, I would just like to say how honored I am to have been given this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to present this speech. Words are not enough to express how grateful I am to be in this position where I'm at. When I first found out that I was the one who will deliver the graduation speech as a representative of the GAS strand, I was flabbergasted beyond comprehension. Not because I thought I didn't deserve it, but because I know to myself my fellow graduates are just as deserving of this opportunity as I am. Furthermore, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the institution, the school administration, staff, teachers, and everyone included in the San Lorenzo family. You treated us as if we were your own family. My gratitude towards the school knows no bounds. Not only did the school give us a place to learn, it gave us a second home, where we were able to learn proper moral values and virtues. We want to thank each and every single one of you for always seeing the best in us and for never giving up on us. We're not the brightest students, and we tend to be stubborn from time to time, but not a single teacher made us feel inferior to each other. Teachers come and go, one replaces the other, but it doesn't mean we forgot about you and the lessons you taught us. We would like to express how grateful we are for emboldening us to become the best version of ourselves. You're one of the biggest factors to why we're here, standing tall, standing proud. And of course, a huge nod towards our parents for always being there for us ever since we took our first breath in this world. Mere words are not enough to express how fortunate we are to have you as our parents. We wouldn't be the person we are today if it wasn't because of your love, guidance, and support. There are some people in our lives who are just temporary. Friends come and go, even our closest ones. But there are some people who will permanently be in our lives, and those people are our family. No matter how bad things are, no matter how hopeless you think the situation is, our family will always have our back, no matter what. Their love for us is second to none, and always remember that blood will always be thicker than water. My fellow graduates, here we are! We finally made it! We're graduating. It seems like it was just yesterday when all of us were just freshman students facing the new world of high school, and all of us unequivocally had no idea what we were up against. I'm not going to mention names because I don't want any of you to feel left out. Some of you I've known since I was a freshman, some of you I've just recently met. But regardless of how long I've known you, I will never forget any of you. I want you to know that I love each and every single one of you equally. We had our ups and downs, the highs and the lows. And we don't always see each other eye to eye, but at the end of the day, you people are the best classmates a student could ever have. And I will never replace you for anything. This is it, a new journey for all of us. We're about to embark on a ship towards uncharted waters. But regardless, I know for a fact that we're always going to be there for each other. Come what may. I don't usually say this, but I want you guys to know that I love you from the bottom of my heart. I'll cherish all of the memories we shared together and I will take them to my grave. And last, but certainly not the least, I would like to thank the man above for making all of this possible. God is the sole reason why I'm in the position where I'm currently at. People often ask me, how are you able to achieve such a feat? I mean, you're not evidently known as a hardworking student. I say to them, well, it's because I have God. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, states that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And he most certainly did. He helped erase all of my problems that were hindering me from reaching my fullest potential. I would also like to thank God for staying with me and my fellow graduates through thick and thin. We owe it to you, our Lord and Savior. I guess this is goodbye. After this day, we'll no longer be SLRN students, but know that we will always be SLRNs at heart. And for the last time, say it with me, fellow graduates. San Lorenzo, sa puso ko. The God in me greets the God in you. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a great rest of your day.
to the graduates of Batch 2021 of San Lorenzo Ruiz Center of Studies and Schools, congratulations, congratulations, congratulations. In behalf of the SLRCSS Alumni Association, I would like to congratulate you three times. The first is for being able to successfully continue your studies despite of the COVID-19 pandemic. The second is for the new opportunities as you leave your virtual classrooms and enter the real world. And third is for upholding Christian values during these very challenging times. I am very proud to welcome you to the global community of SLRian graduates. Whatever path you take, whether you pursue further studies, open a business, or land a job, we, your fellow SLRians, are always here with you. Wherever you may be, SLRians shine! Keep in touch, and we are very excited to see you in our future alumni activities. Don't forget to add us on Facebook via our SLRCSS Alumni International Network. San Lo sa puso, mabuhay po kayong lahat at hanggang sa muli nating pagkikita. Maraming salamat.
We are all afraid of uncertainty. For instant tests, giving up all we must to pursue a dream that may or may not work out, are sometimes what other people think about us. But thank you for those people who prioritize us, their children, before their own. For those people who wakes up in the morning to prepare our stuff before we open our eyes. And most importantly, to those who stays by our side until the end despite of our foolishness, stubbornness, and endless tantrums. We would like to express our deepest gratitude to none other than our beloved parents for their unending love, guidance, and patience. We would also like to extend our appreciation for supporting us to gain and regain our confidence and dignity all through tough moments, for supporting us to step out of the fear of failure and start a new chapter of life at the edge of our comfort zone. You made us realize that we are all stronger and more capable than we thought we are. A simple thank you is not enough to show your appreciation for everything you have done to make our lives comfortable and happy. And for that, we owe you our lives. Time will come when we will leave your side to start a life of our own. But always remember, no matter where life takes us, you are and will always be part of our lives. Because no matter how old we may be, we will always be a little girl and little boy. And we thank God for giving us a parent like you. We all love you and thank you so much for everything.
A pleasant day to everyone. Life is really full of surprises. Who would ever think that classes this school year 2020-2021 would be different from what we used to do in the past, the face-to-face instruction. The pandemic has brought us a lot of realizations and experiences. We have learned to value life, time, people, education, and a lot more. But in spite of this pandemic, teaching and learning continue. We have adjusted our curriculum, our delivery of instruction, from face-to-face to online teaching and learning, and in a lot of ways made several modifications. Truly, God is good that we were able to finish this school year with success. We also owe it to you, our dear graduates, for your patience and perseverance, to your parents and guardians as well, for their unending support and understanding. This is the time to celebrate every bit of your success, our success. You deserve a round of applause. All your efforts have been paid off. I'm very happy and proud of what you have become. Graduation has always been an exciting, memorable, and a much-awaited event in the life of every student. It marks the beginning of a new chapter in one's educational journey. Your graduation is certainly an achievement, that your success is not a surprise. It's well deserved. You are now about to take a step forward in your educational journey. May you always bring with you the knowledge you have learned, as well as the values that were imbibed in you during your stay in this institution. There is no shortcut to success, but I firmly believe that you will achieve whatever you have dreamed of, as long as you believe in yourself and put your best foot forward in whatever you do. Just focus on what you want to achieve. Remember that you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. To our dear parents and guardians, thank you for the trust you have given us as your partners in the education and formation of your children. We look forward to having more years with you as our partners. To our graduates and completers for this school year 2020-2021, in behalf of San Lorenzo Ruiz Center of Studies and Schools administrators, teaching and non-teaching personnel, congratulations for a job well done. I wish you good luck. God bless.
Excellent, reaching the stars. Christians, we serve and we care.